Uganda national netball team Shukwens has lost their first Premier League stage 2 game against the fourth ranked Jamaica to top Group G with 2 points.
We want to see how he's going to manage Fowler inside the circle there.
Yeah, just Cholak and Nanfuka with that previous World Cup.
By testing Irene Ayaro in the wing attack during the Trinidad and Tobago game, it looked obvious that Menuba would start the game alongside Shadia Nasanga, and Irene Ayaro was likely to play wing attack, a position played by Nora Longse. However, the coach paired Irene Ayaro and Menuba, and the duo seemed not to match.
She's to the side in a way. So difficult, fast-paced moving again. And this is what Jamaica, they're getting the doubles now on this one.
Yes, and this is what Jamaica likes. They
In the second quarter, Mugera observed that the goal attacking side and the wing attacking side were failing him. He's making only 2 changes, substituting Irene Ayaro in the goal attack and Ayaro replaced Nora Longse in the wing attack. The combination worked perfectly, more so in shooting, and Ayaro managed to control the game by slowing it down, though the damage that gave Jamaica a lead of 7 goals in the first half had already been caused.
And when you think they won the first 15-12, just shows you how they've managed to stretch.
It's really a tough loss for Team Uganda, but still, like, it is an opportunity for us because we have got to learn so many things for, like, Team Uganda when we are playing Jamaica. First and foremost, like, our passes are not being very okay, and our spacing was not all that well, very well. And at least tomorrow we shall be off, and we shall utilize that time for at least correcting whatever mistake we have made today, so that it can help us to improve on upcoming games.
Again, playing a winger.
Of course, I can play any position which coach tells me to play, because it's not just like by surprise, because at times once when we were training like this, he always keeps on telling me I should always be very ready for any position which he will take me to play. But for me, I don't see it very bad, because at times I see it is very better when you are playing more than like 2 or 3 positions, because anything can happen with like any player. Let me say on the shooting side, once when somebody gets like a problem, they can switch me to shooting side or like wing attack. So I don't see it's a problem on my side. Yeah, of course, like we as the team, at least we have really fought very hard, because if we didn't go very hard as a team, I think the range was going to be too much. But still, because we had to work extra hard, because we had a plan of beating the team, but still, I think it wasn't our day. But still, I know each and every player had got to learn a lot of things from today's game. And for the rest of the games, I know we shall still make it better.
Very impressive from the girls, playing a very tough team like Jamaica. And with a great performance, of course, they did not win, but they showed character and they came back, they fought back. So for me, I'm very happy and pleased that I made it to come watch the game live in the stadium. So they must keep fighting, keep giving their best, and all the best in their next encounter.
If Shukwens are to finish sixth or fifth, they need to win the remaining 2 matches in Group D against South Africa and Wales.
After suffering a defeat from Jamaica, national netball team Shukwens will go into rest and then return in action on Wednesday to face Wales. Their last encounter was during the 2015 Netball World Cup, and it ended in favour of the Shukwens. If at all Shukwens is to finish 5th or 6th, it has to win all the 3 remaining matches in Group G. I'm Olivia Nakate, reporting for Urban TV Sports here live in Cape Town, South Africa.